dignitaries, participants, ladies and gentlemen. I, Syed Shaban Bukhari, the deputy to Shahi Imam, Jama Masjid, Delhi, the largest mosque in Asia. Qibla Syed Ahmed Bukhari Sahib, bring for all of you from 250 million Muslims of India and from 500,000 Imams of Masjids of India a message of peace, harmony and conciliation. There are many commonalities in faiths like institution of the creation and the creator, institution of evil and good, institution of repentance and accountability, and with many others. One common institution is that of the place of worship. Mosque, synagogue, mandir, church, etc. fall in this category. In these places of worship, while assembling, praying and joining the proceedings, all stand and stay as equals, holding a true sense of companionship and fellowship. In doing so, negativity turns into positive aspirations and vibrations. The essential takes in prayers like the attributes of self-discipline, sanity, moderation, fellowship, peace, harmony, and human dignity brings about natural transformation of mind, body, soul, and spirit. This applies to all religions, faiths, and beliefs. This common factor of accepting and according human dignity to the places of worship by the followers of all practicing faiths provide a common ground for the followers of all faiths to respect each other's sensitivities and coexist peacefully. Human dignity is a subject of universal concern and priority. Any attack on it by either side is condemnable, and humanity has to be on one pitch and platform in fighting this menace. Islam stands for peaceful coexistence and accepts the legacy of 124,000 prophets, which begins from Adam and concludes at Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, leaving no room for fight with each other. Jews, Christians and Muslims share the same legacy of faith. Let us work together as one family with sisters and brothers in other faiths to create a more peaceful and harmonious world. Indulging in blame game or subscribing to conspiracy theory is not going to serve anybody's purpose. It is also time for the world community to work for the resolution of conflicts wherever they are and whatever dimensions they have taken. Before I close, I would like to express my gratitude to the organizers for giving me this opportunity while looking forward to such useful exchanges in future as well. I, on behalf of the Imam of the Grand Mosque in Delhi, assure you of our full cooperation in these ventures of peace and harmony. Thank you.